So this is everything you need to know about the Hollywood sign and how Hugh Hefner, the founder of Playboy, actually saved it from destruction. Let's learn.
All right. So in 1923, the Hollywoodland sign went up by a real estate development group. Originally, it was only planned to last for 1 to 2 years, and the letters stand nearly 50 feet tall for each letter, which is staggering. Back then, it had over 4,000 lights, and all those lights were flashing, and it was alternating. It would say Hollywoodland, and then all of Hollywoodland would light up and flash. It's one way that the real estate development group got a chance to harness all of the marketing power without having to worry about permits or any of the development, because nowadays you can't have anything like that happen.
100 years later, how does that sign still exist? The sign essentially was falling apart, and they needed to raise $250,000 to restore the sign to its original glory. Hugh Hefner held a charity auction at his house, and each letter was auctioned off at $27,700, and we got a wide range of people that were bidding on the signs. Hollywood rock stars and musicians stepped up, from Gene Autry, a country singer and actor, to legendary rock superstar Alice Cooper.
Stick around, hang out with us.
Cool. Yeah, we'll stay and hang around with us. With Alice Cooper.
We're not worthy!
In the end, each person bought one letter of the Hollywood sign, and it was saved, and its glory today is, I don't know. I only read this like a week ago, and that's it.